In this episode, we are visiting two famous locations near the town of Paige in Arizona. Horseshoe Bend near the town Paige in Arizona is very easy to find, and there's a fairly big parking lot for parking. There's also a fine path towards the bend. The main vantage point is easy to find, and you will only have to decide if you want something in the foreground or not. A lot of photographers go here to catch the sun and a sun star just at the moment when the sun hits the horizon. In my experience, you actually get the best light after sunset, since the sun will probably do an afterburn on the clouds above Horseshoe Bend. The afterburn is the effect where the sun lights up the clouds from beneath in those deep red colors after the sun has set. On top of that, you don't need to fight with highlights on cliffs where the sun hits while it's still visible. And after the sun has set, most people will leave, so there should be more space for you to find a better composition if you want to. The Horseshoe Bend is very, very big. It's a huge location and it is immensely epic. I only just got the entire bend within one frame at 16mm, but I can highly recommend to go for 14mm to get a bit more of the sky. You can, of course, also zoom into the details and isolate parts of this spectacular scene. Another place and very iconic location to visit near Paige is the Antelope Canyon. The Antelope Canyon contains of an upper and lower part and other sections too. And those two sections are located only a 10-minute drive from Paige. We did go to Lower Antelope Canyon, but because it has become very commercialized, I focused all my energy on taking pictures instead of video, since we only had 2 hours to visit these beautiful canyons. We went on a special photography tour where we had 2 hours with a guide, and you can't enter the canyon unless it's with a guide. It was only Sophie and I who went on the tour, so luckily we weren't pushed around by other tourists. The guide was very eager to show us all the good places to photograph, which kind of removed some of the magic of being at this place. I have to admit, I'm torn between two sets of mind from my visit to Antelope Canyon. On one hand, the fact you have to have a guide disturbs the experience and takes away the feeling of exploration. But the guide also coordinates with other guides so that all the tourists doesn't disturb each other too much. We even went way out of season and didn't even have to stand in line to enter the canyon, but the amount of tourists were still annoying since the space in the canyon is very narrow. Overall, it's a highly commercialized experience with way too many customers. On the other hand, there's a reason why this place is so famous. The Antelope Canyons are very special and they are very beautiful, which adds up to being a big experience. If you're in the area and don't plan to come by anytime in the future, it's definitely worth a visit. But take into account it's commercialized and extremely touristy, and you have to book tours in advance. Photography-wise, bring a tripod which is easy to work with, and if you have a camera with an articulating screen, you will save yourself from a lot of stress. If you're going for those iconic sunbeam pictures, the upper Antelope Canyon is the place to go. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode and got a bit of information about decisions to make in regard to visiting, especially Antelope Canyons. I would highly appreciate a like, and you can subscribe to the channel if you want to follow on even more. In the next episode, we are going to one of the most iconic and legendary landscapes in the entire world, the famous Monument Valley.